What is up? It is Red, the rideshare ginger. It is December 26th, about 12. No work for me today, maybe late tonight, but probably no work at all for me today. Heading back to Rockford to go see a friend that's in from Colorado, so gotta take some time out of the day to go do that. But I did wanna pop in, summarize my Saturday, way back when on December 22nd that I haven't put anything out for yet. So it was a good day overall. It wasn't a crazy grind. I did 15 hours in total. Could have made more, but it wasn't a perfect day. But it's also, you know, holiday weekend heading into Christmas, and I didn't necessarily hit the numbers the way I thought I was going to. I didn't hit the surge the way I thought I was going to. So overall, goal for the day was to be in Hinsdale about 4 to 6 p.m. somewhere in there and just work from there, and then get to St. Charles by about 11 and then work that area the rest of the night. That was the goal. So 4 to 6 into Hinsdale and then work my way over to St. Charles. That's where I thought things were going to surge. That's where I thought I wanted to be. And the reason I want to be St. Charles versus anywhere from 11 to 2 is it's probably the closest place with big surge to my house. It's about 30 minutes from home to me, and let me adjust this real quick. I'm not gonna see that surge anywhere else 30 minutes from home for me, so that's the best way to go for me, in my opinion. So quickly to summarize the numbers, start with on Lyft. Lyft, I did, as you can see here, $106.75. And as you can see, there's that trend of low tips, and I'm gonna try to start taking a look, see what the issue is here. That could be the vehicle now at this point. I'm a big believer in tips come from the vehicle as well as service, but I think a lot of the vehicle has to do with it. And then, so tips of 1808, total of 106.75. Flip over to Uber. Uber, I did 173.66. Very low tips over there too. And that's a total of 280.41 for the day for me. But I had a cleaning fee again, so back-to-back weekends, a cleaning fee of $80, so it took me to $360.41 on the day. Solid day for 15 hours when you really sit down and think about it. But it could be better, but I am also, that's probably my biggest day, I think $280.41. I exclude the cleaning fee when looking at it, but $280.41 is probably my biggest day of doing X only. I don't think I've ever done anything that big on X only. I'd have to really look back, but when I first started, when I was doing, you know, consistently 12 to 18 hour days on Lyft only, I maybe beat it at some point, but I doubt it. So the way my night kind of went, so worked most of the morning, started at 11 a.m. and kind of worked things around. And made some decent money. It was kind of slow moving, but got some money going. And then started making my way towards Hinsdale at about, I was in downtown. I started my making my way there at about 3:30. I ended up getting there right around 7, somewhere right in there. And then sat in there at 7. I got a request. No surge on Lyft, but I took it. I said, why not? If there's not a whole lot popping just yet, there wasn't much surge. There wasn't the surge that I thought there was going to be. So I took that request, dipped out of there, ended up in Bolingbrook. Wasn't too happy about that. Pretty far south for me. And decent trip, you know, about $25 trip, but ended up way too far south. At this point, Hinsdale started surging a little bit. I'm like, well, damn, but nothing too big. And then in Bolingbrook, I got a 45-minute plus request after being there for about 10 minutes. I'm like, great. Hopefully, it'll take me back to where I want to be. I ended up here to take a look at this trip. Ended up going Bolingbrook to Chicago for $36.15, so to downtown for $36.15. So not a bad trip overall, not a great trip, but it worked for me. And it got me to Chicago, not to Hinsdale. At this point, Hinsdale's surging, so I'm like, fuck, let me get back there. Well, I try slow rolling myself back to Hinsdale, and I'm trying to do it without a destination filter. So riding without a destination filter, see if I can make it happen. I get down Irving Park about halfway from Wrigley area and get a ping. Takes me right back to where I started, back towards Wrigley. I'm like, fine, let's go back down Irving Park again. Somehow I ended up right on Irving Park again. So take the next ping, Got started there and started heading back down Irving Park again. Got all the way to the end of Irving Park, basically, about to, get to where I want to be, start heading in the right direction. Got another ping. Ping took me all the way back to the beginning of Irving Park. I'm like, son of a bitch. So I ended up there again. So started heading my way back down again. And at some time at this point, I'm pretty sure I got a red light ticket down Irving Park. Saw the lights flash. Another car was by me. We'll see what comes through, but I'm pretty sure I got one. Not a red light ticket, but a speeding ticket. Camera ticket. So start heading back down Irving Park again. This time I get a ping halfway down Irving Park, but this takes me a little bit further south. I end up on North Avenue. So take that ride. Now I'm starting to take North Avenue out. It's probably about 9 o'clock at this point, 8:39. And my goal is still St. Charles by 11, 12 at the latest. So heading on my way out. Get pretty far down North Avenue, take a couple of pings, and got some stuff going the right way. And then finally got a request over in Brookfield area, some decent Surge. Surge popped up on top of me at one point for 750. So I grabbed a 750 Surge ride out of there and took that, but it took me back towards the city. But then after that, started heading back the other way. I eventually got into a decent area, Oak Brook area, picked up a ride from there. And it was going to Schaumburg, but it was picking up from a house. Not too bad, but that ride ended up being my cleaning fee. I'll talk a little bit more about that in a separate video. I don't want to ramble on too long here. But ultimately, that got me up into Schaumburg, so 35, 40 minutes from St. Charles Point. And it was about, I think, 12:30 when I dropped off, somewhere right in there. And then I had to go clean my vehicle. So finished up the cleaning at about 1 o'clock. And at this point, I'm like, fuck, do I still want to go to St. Charles? I'm like, screw it, let's get to St. Charles. Get to St. Charles at 1:30. Not a whole lot of surge happening. Some surge had popped off for about 550 for a little bit and not really much PT. Got a ride request. I said, fuck it, I'm going to take it. Take the ride request. It takes me over towards Elmhurst in that area. So about a 20, 25 minute ride. And turns out, as I'm taking a look back at the chat, the whole time that I'm over here, St. Charles is popping off for $15, $18, $20. So if I just would have waited and was patient, I would have picked up a better trip. I ended up doing, $40 on that, or $30. It was a $19 trip plus 10 tip on that trip that I took. No surge, no PT, nothing. If I would have just waited, been patient, I probably could have hit a couple of St. Charles trips at $15 to $20 a piece and made the same amount, shorter amount of time, and been closer to home. But at that point, it was a little after 2. Decided to just head straight home from there. Don't try to chance it and head back to St. Charles. So ended up heading home. As you can tell, a couple of mistakes in the day. Didn't sit on Hinsdale long enough, took a ride out. And didn't sit on St. Charles long enough, took a ride out. So I'm going to try to be a little more patient next time when I have an inkling that something is going to be coming. Only reason I took the ride is just because it was Saturday, holiday weekend of Christmas. I'm like, maybe St. Charles isn't going to surge like it normally does. Normal weekend, I'll definitely sit on that always. It's always going to surge there, $18 to $20. That's just what happens. And when I get back into my select vehicle, select surges there too. So overall, it's a good place to be. That's where I'm going to target on the weekends. But like I said, no working for me today. Hopefully you learn a little bit from my mistakes. I'll try to be less of a jackass going forward and be a little more patient. And like always, like, comment, share, do what you want. Send me questions. I'll try to answer questions best I can in the comment section. If I see that there's something that's worth a full video, I'll do a full video. I think I got a couple of things coming up here soon, but got my videos out that I'm telling you I'm getting out. I got this one done for Saturday, got the Christmas video out, and then I got to get a Turo video out here soon, and then we'll just keep it rolling, see what I'm doing. Hopefully I have the new vehicle before the end of the week. But until next time, thanks again for watching.